both stand. You stand, okay? Okay, family photos. Take a look. Take a look. Look over here. So I'm here to talk to you about Jesus Christ today. The Bible says, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Now, you may say that you're free today, but are you truly free? Are you a slave to sin? The Bible says that the Lord Jesus came to set the captives free. Now, what does that mean? Well, many of you today are slaves. Slaves to pornography. Slaves to alcohol. Slaves to drugs. Many people today are slaves to philandering. To wickedness. Drive carefully, people. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved, my friends. The Bible says there's no other name given under heaven among men whereby we must be saved. Only the name of Jesus Christ can save, has the power to save from sin. Do you know that, my friends? We live in an age when people are attempting to rewrite truth. People are attempting to corrupt the truth, but the truth is inviolable. The truth cannot be corrupted. Jesus said, all who are of the truth will hear my voice. Jesus said, my sheep, they hear my voice and they follow me and I give unto them eternal life. Oh, follow the Lord Jesus Christ today. Don't die in your sin. Don't die as a rebel against an omnipotent creator. God, by definition, is omnipotent. God is almighty. You cannot challenge almighty God and hope to win. What's your objection? How you doing?
Objection?
Or question or comment, whatever.
No, I was going to ask.
Yes, sir.
How long are you going to be here for?
Long time.
Well, if you see any homeless people, can you give us a big kiss?
Yeah.
Thanks, bro. Keep reaching.
God bless. What's your name, man?
I'm Josh.
Thank you, Josh. I'll give it definitely. If I see a homeless person, I'll give it to him. Yeah, man.
Wait, what's your name?
Dan.
Dan, nice to meet you.
God bless you. Thank you.
God bless you. Keep doing the good thing.
Yes, sir. Oh, I'm sorry.
No, you're good.
Yeah, thank you. My dear friends, do you know Jesus Christ today? The Bible says Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Do you recognize that you're a sinner, or are you righteous in your own eyes? The Bible says, do you see a man who's wise in his own eyes? There's more hope for a fool than for him. Are you righteous in your own eyes? Are you wise by your own estimation? There's more hope for a fool than for you if that's the case. I pray that you would put your faith in Jesus Christ, that your hope would be in his righteousness. Oh, my dear friends, God so loved this world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes on him would not perish, but have eternal life. Do you know the truth today? The truth, my friends, that you've sinned against a holy God. God is holy. God is transcendent. God is of purer eyes than to behold evil. Fear God and give him glory. Believe on Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. Why are you so rude? Why are you so intolerant? Why are you so intolerant today? Oh, my dear friends, what is this madness of absurdity that we see in the inherent secular worldview? If you don't know God, then by definition you have embraced absurdity. Then you call foolishness your kinswoman. What's that? Talk to me, bro. I couldn't hear you, bro. Get an amp. Couldn't hear you. If you got something that you really believe in, you should get an app and talk about it, because I couldn't hear you. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. Young man, remember your Creator while you're young. You don't know when you're going to die. If you are wise, you would apply your heart to get wisdom. You would number your days. You would seek the truth more than gold or silver or Bitcoin. You can't trust the economy. You can't trust in the Republicans or the Democrats, but you can put your faith in the Lord God of heaven and earth. You can put your trust in Jesus Christ. Why? He is the perfect God in the flesh, and he demonstrated his love in that while we were yet sinners. Do you acknowledge you're a sinner? If you do not recognize that you have sinned against God, then you do not qualify for forgiveness of that sin. My friends, you must have the humility to recognize your need of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Oh, my dear friends, you don't know when you're going to die. Do you know when you're going to be hit by a bus or hit by a stray bullet? Do you know when you're going to have a heart attack? Do you know? You don't know the day of death. But if you are wise, you would make peace with God. If you are wise, you would cultivate favor with God. God bless you, dear friend. I hope that you know Jesus today. I hope that you know God. Many people today are like sheep. They're wandering aimlessly, scattered, with no shepherd. The Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, he is the good shepherd. You know why? He lays down his life for the sheep. The Lord Jesus Christ laid down his life voluntarily. No man took his life from him. Do you love Jesus Christ, or do you deny the existence of God? The Bible says, the fool says in his heart, there is no God. I pray that you're not a fool who outrightly dismisses the idea of God. There is a transcendent, immortal, invisible, all-powerful, omnipotent God. And when we die, my dear friends, we all must face judgment. When we die, we're all going to stand before God. Look to Jesus Christ today. Don't lose your soul. The Bible says, what does it profit if you gain the whole world and lose your soul? Don't lose your soul today, my dear friend. Jesus said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Many of you today are slaves. Slaves to your own lusts, slaves to your own depravity, slaves to your own corruptions. But the Lord Jesus, he preaches liberty to the captives. There's hope in the blessed name of Jesus Christ. Oh, please, my dear friends, don't die as an enemy of God. Don't die proudly refusing heaven. No longer stiffen your neck against God. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, and he will lift you up. Believe on the name of Jesus Christ, and you shall be saved. Oh, there's no greater name. Do you love God today? Oh, do you love God? Say amen if you love God. God gives you your breath. God gives you your life. God gives you your food. God gives you your car. God gives you your shoes, your clothes. God gives you your cell phone, your earphones. God gives you your books. God gives you everything you have. Are you grateful to God, sir? Are you grateful to God, or do you hate God? Do you hate the idea of God? Are you foolishly dismissive of his reality? Oh, my friends, the Bible says, the fool says in his heart, there is no God. I pray that you are not so foolish. I pray that you are not so foolish as to deny the obvious self-evident reality of a transcendent, omnipotent, omniscient God. God gives you life and breath every day. Oh, my dear madam, dear ladies, don't challenge God. Don't be so foolish and so rebellious against the true God. Submit to Jesus Christ today. Oh, believe on the Lord before it's too late. Before you die in your sins. Before it's too late. Don't die in your sin. Look to Jesus Christ. Oh, my friend, look to him. God bless you, man. Bhagwan Bahut Parishudur Hai. Look to Jesus Christ and you will be saved. Don't die in your sin. Oh, my dear friends, God bless you. Don't die in your sin, young lady, young man. Don't die as an enemy of God. God sees your thoughts. God knows about those dirty thoughts that even your mother doesn't know about, that your wife doesn't know about, that your lover doesn't know about. God, my friends, God is angry with the wicked every day. God bless you. Do you know Jesus, ma'am? Do you know God? Do you know Jesus? I pray, I hope that you know God. The Bible says that in this is love, not that we love God, but that He loved us, gave His Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Do you know God today? Do you know the truth? Jesus said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. God bless you. Why are you doing that, bro? You don't like Jesus? Come, what's your problem, man? Why are you so angry? Why are you so hate-filled? Why is your soul so filthy, young man? Come, talk to me. Why do you have such anger and hatred in your heart? Look at all of this hatred, my friends. Do you know that there is a day coming in which God will judge this world in righteousness? God is going to judge every person. You cannot escape the day of death. It doesn't matter how strong you are. It doesn't matter how educated you are. Every person must stand before God. Look to Jesus Christ. Oh, Jesus says, believe on the Lord and you shall be saved. Or the Bible says, you shall know the truth and the truth shall make you free. Do you know the truth today? Do you know the truth? Jesus said, all who are of the truth will hear His voice. Do you love God's word today? Do you love the truth, or do you despise His word? Does the preaching of the Bible agitate you? Does the proclamation of the kingdom of God, does it irritate you? I pray that you are not so foolishly inclined. I pray that today you have been sensitized by God's Spirit to love God. Do you love God, sir? Do you know God gives you your food and your water every day? God gives you the strength, the vitality you have. Don't die in your sin. Oh, the Bible says, if you do not believe that I am He, you shall die in your sins. If you do not believe that Jesus Christ is God in the flesh, you shall die in your sins. Please don't die in your sins. Don't die as an enemy of God today. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. Oh, please submit to His sovereignty. If you submit to Jesus Christ, He will raise you from the deadness of your sin. Many of you today, you're enslaved to sin. You're enslaved to the lusts of your flesh, the lusts of your eyes, and the pride of life. Oh, fear God and give Him glory. Fear God and give Him glory. You don't know the day of death. You don't know when you're going to die. Believe on Jesus Christ. Don't lose your soul, my dear friends. Don't lose your soul. What does it profit a man if he gain the whole world and lose his soul? What can a man give in exchange for his soul? I got a question for you. What does it profit if you gain the whole world and lose your soul? Don't lose your soul today, young person. Don't lose your soul. There is nothing, my friends, in this world as glorious as the name of Jesus Christ. Do you fear God? Do you love God? If you love God, my friends, it's only because you have first been loved by God. The Bible says, in this is love. Not that we love God, but that He loved His people and gave His Son to be a propitiation, a sacrifice for sin. Sacrifice, young man. There's a sacrifice that is required for sin. We must stand before God for our life. Unless you put your faith in Jesus Christ, you have no hope. Please don't die in your sin today. Please don't die as an enemy of God. Why will you lose your soul? Why will you persist in your sin? No longer refuse heaven. No longer stubbornly resist God. Don't kick against the pricks. The Bible says that we should have the mind of Christ, who being in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but that Jesus Christ humbled Himself, and Jesus Christ became obedient to the point of death, even the death on a cross. Wherefore God has highly exalted Jesus Christ and given Him a name above every name, that at the name of Jesus Christ every tongue would confess and every knee would bow. Every person would acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Do you acknowledge that Jesus Christ is God in the flesh? Don't fight against God. Don't resist God. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, and He will lift you up. What is the purpose of your life? Have you ever pondered the meaning of your existence? What's the purpose of life? You ever thought about that? We're all going to die one day. It doesn't matter how nice your car is. It doesn't matter how much bling you've got. Everyone dies. If you are wise, you'd make peace with God today. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't challenge God, young person. Don't tempt fate. Don't challenge God. You don't know the day of death. When will you die? Oh, make peace with God today. Make peace with God today. Don't die in your sins. The Bible says, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Do you know Jesus Christ today? Do you know Jesus? Well, if you don't know Jesus, then I don't know. All I can tell you is there's a place called hell. I don't want anyone to go to hell. I'm sorry, you're right. God bless. I don't want anyone to go to hell. I don't want anybody out here to drop into an eternal place of suffering for their sin. I have good news today. The good news is that Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners. Young person, God bless you. Do you know Jesus today? The Bible says, you shall know the truth, then the truth shall make you free. You say, I'm free, I'm not a slave. Are you a slave to pornography? Are you a slave to sin? The Lord Jesus Christ can set you free from your sinful corruptions. The Lord Jesus Christ can set you free from your depravity, from your turpitude, from your sin. Do you know Jesus today, my dear friend? Oh, you may feel strong, you may feel brave, you may feel invincible, but when you die, and die you shall, there'll be no second chances then. Make peace with God today. Make peace in the name of Jesus Christ. Don't die in your sin. Don't die as an enemy of God. Make peace with God today. Oh, there's no other name given under heaven among men whereby you must be saved. Only the name of Jesus Christ. Do you know Jesus today, dear sir? God bless you. Nihama. Do you know Jesus? Do you know God? If you don't know God, then your life is hopeless. God bless you, my dear friends. Do you know Jesus Christ? I care about you enough to tell you, my friends, that there's a place called hell. There's a literal place called hell. Hey, apkanam kahe? Apkanam kahe? Miko, you know Hindi, bro? God bless you. I speak Hindi. God bless. God bless. I care about you enough to tell you the hard truth, my friends. I'm not here to sugarcoat the truth. I'm not here to tantalize you with words of health and wealth and prosperity. I'm here to tell you that Jesus Christ can set you free. The Lord Jesus can set you free from your sin. Give honor to Jesus Christ today. Believe on the name of Jesus Christ. Young person, don't die in your sin. Don't die and go to hell for your sin. Look to Jesus Christ. Oh, believe on His name. His name is the name above every name. Look to Him and be saved. Look to the name of Jesus Christ. His name is great and greatly to be praised. You know why? God gives you your life and your breath every day. God gives you mercies in the form of sunlight and rain. Be careful, young man. Be careful. You don't know the day of death. Remember your Creator while you're young. Fear God and give Him glory. Please, young person, don't die as an enemy of God. Make peace with God today. Make peace with God. God sent His only Son into the world. God demonstrated His love. He proved His love by sending His only Son, His only begotten Son. Do you love God, sir? What's that? Don't be deceived, man. God is not mocked. See, this person thinks he can mock God. You can't mock God, sir. You can't mock God and hope to win. When you die, oh, when you die, there'll be no laughing then. There'll be only mourning and weeping and gnashing of teeth. Oh, the Bible says, don't be deceived. God is not mocked. God is not mocked, young person. Don't mock God. Humble yourself reverently, respectfully. Bow the knee to Jesus Christ. Genuflect to His majesty. Give honor and fealty and loyalty to Jesus Christ. Honor His person. Praise His name. The name of Jesus Christ is the name above every name. I'm going to Christmas carol for you today. I know it's a little bit early, but hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies, with angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Do you believe on Jesus Christ? Do you love God? Do you know what the word Bethlehem means in Hebrew? Bethlehem means the house of bread. Why? Jesus Christ is the bread from heaven. He is the true manna from heaven. He is the living bread. Eat of this bread and drink of this water. Jesus said, I give the water of life. If anyone drinks of the water that I offer, he'll never thirst again. Please, my dear friends, come to Jesus Christ and live. Turn from your wicked way and look to Christ. Oh, His name is great. Oh, blessings be upon the name of Jesus Christ. Do you love His name? Do you fear His name? His name is the name above every name. Our names will fade into oblivion. Our names will fade into obscurity. But the name of Jesus Christ, the eternal, transcendent, immortal, glorious name of God, will endure forever. The Word of God endures forever. And the Bible says, the Word became flesh and dwelled among us. Jesus Christ lived in this world. He lived and He died and He came back from the dead. He did, my friends, what we could never do. He came back from the dead. God bless you. God bless you. Do you know Jesus Christ today? God bless. Amen. Amen. Jesus said, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Go into all the world. Why? Because heaven and hell are real. Heaven and hell are real places. They're more real than this world. God is more real than this world. God bless you. My friends, God's glory is greater than anything in this world. Believe on the name of Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. I'm concerned. There's lots of people out here today who claim to be Christians. Many of you today, you're self-deceived. Some of you today, you may think that you're right with God. But the Bible says the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? The Bible says that your heart is deceived. That's why you must be born again. My friends, I'm not here to patronize you. I'm not here to say I'm holier than you are. I'm here to point you to your need for Christ. The Bible says that the Word of God became flesh and dwelled among us. God became a man, Jesus Christ. Oh, God in the flesh, and we beheld His glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Do you love Jesus Christ today? Do you know Jesus Christ? What's up, Star Wars? What's that? Can't hear you. God bless you. God bless this young man. I pray that you save his soul. Lord, save this man's soul. See, the Bible says the fool says in his heart, there is no God. You know what the Bible says? The fool says in his heart, there is no God. Do you recognize that there is a God? Do you acknowledge that there is a creator, that there is a prime mover? Or do you foolishly dismiss the idea of God outrightly? Oh, please don't die in your sins. If you don't know Jesus Christ, if you don't know God, then you'll die in your sins in a hopeless state. Oh, the Bible says, if you do not believe that Jesus Christ is He, you shall die in your sins. Please, my friends, don't die in your sins today. Be wise, fear God, and give Him glory. God gives you your life and your breath. God gives you everything you have. If you were wise today, you would make peace with God by believing on Jesus Christ. My friends, you cannot run from God. You cannot hide from the truth. No matter what you do in life, death comes to every person. Death is inevitable. Everyone must die. Why? The Bible says the wages of sin is death. What's that? You want to talk? God bless you. God bless you guys. How you doing today? I'm talking to people about Jesus Christ. Do you know Jesus, my friend? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. There is only one way to God, only through the blessed name of Jesus Christ. If you don't know Jesus Christ, then you have no hope. The Bible says, look unto me, all the ends of the earth, and be saved. Do you know Jesus today? Or do you know only yourself? Are you obsessed with yourself? Are you self-absorbed? Are you self-obsessed? My friends, please don't die in your sins. Don't die as an enemy of God. Jesus said, the Bible says the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God, the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. You don't have to die in your sin like a dog. Many people today, they live like dogs. They live only for carnal impulse. They live only for primal instinct. They live a subhuman existence. They have no fear of God. But the Lord Jesus, He can give you a crown of dignity, a crown of honor. He can, my friends, save you from your sin, from your moral turpitude, from your moral depravity, from the radical corruption. You must be born again. You must be radically rebooted. The hardware of your soul must be rebooted, my dear friends. There is a Trojan horse. There's malware called sin. It's terminal. There is a terminal carcinogen in your soul called sin. You must be born again, Jesus said, if you would see or enter the kingdom of heaven. Do you love God today, my dear friend? Or does the preaching of the Bible offend you? Does the preaching of the truth irritate you? The Bible says, all who are of the truth hear His voice. Do you delight in His word? Do you rejoice in His word? Or does His word offend you? I pray, my friends, that you are not so foolish as to callously disregard His truth. The Bible says, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Do you know Jesus Christ today, friend? Do you know God? If you don't know God, then you have no hope. Don't die in your sins. Don't die as an enemy of God. Look to Jesus Christ. Oh, the mercy and the blessed compassion of Christ, that He did not spare His own life, but He laid down His life. He sacrificed Himself. He humbled Himself. He became obedient to the point of death, even the death on a cross. Wherefore God has highly exalted Christ. Do you love Jesus Christ today? Are you a friend of God? Or do you hate the truth? Do you love loud music? Do you love shouting at silly games, silly sports games? But the sound of the truth is offensive to you? Examine yourself whether you're in the faith. Examine yourself whether you're in the truth. Or the Bible says you must be born again if you would see or enter the kingdom of God. We must be born again. Do you know why? The Bible says we are born in sin. As soon as man is born, the sparks fly upward. You need to be born again, dear ma'am, dear sir. Without Jesus Christ, you're hopeless. Without Jesus Christ, I'm hopeless. But there's good news today. Oh, there's blessed news. The Bible says Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Do you have the humility, the intellectual honesty? Do you recognize that you've sinned against God? There is an eternal fire. There is an eternal, unquenchable fire. There is an eternal flame, an unquenchable flame. Place called hell. If you burn with lust, if you burn with wicked carnal passion without any fear of God before your eyes, then you will burn in eternal fire called hell. Please don't die and go to hell. Don't die in your sins. Don't be so foolish as to outrightly dismiss the idea of God. Do you believe there's a God? You will. When you die, you will believe there's a God, my friends. You'll know there's a God. You'll see him then. Oh, please, wake up, my friends, from the delusion, the atheist delusion. Today, are you, the Bible says, the fool says in his heart, there is no God. The fool says it. Are you a fool, my friends, or are you wise? Do you tremble at his word? Do you graciously acknowledge God as the giver of life, the giver of breath? Do you graciously acknowledge that God gives you your life and your breath, or do you stubbornly resist heaven? Do you proudly, stiff-neckedly resist heaven? Please, my dear friends, don't die in your sin. Do you know when you're going to die? Oh, you celebrate your birthday with a cake, but do you know the day of death? No person knows the day of death. If you were wise, you'd wake up, my friends. God knows about the sin your mother doesn't know about. God knows about the porn that your father and your mother don't know about. God knows about the crimes that you've done that the police don't know about. And you have a court date. You have a court date. When you die, God will deploy his angels and they will harvest your soul, and your soul will be brought before judgment. You must stand before God for your life. If you are wise, you would make peace with God today. Make peace with Jesus Christ. Don't resist him who speaks. Don't persist in your stubborn sinfulness. If you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you'll be saved. You know that? Don't be deceived, young person. God is not mocked. God is not mocked. You know that? You can't mock a God, my friends, forever. You can't laugh at the truth forever. Where do you die, my friend? Hey, yo, bro, when are you going to die? Do you know when you're going to die? You don't know the day of death. No person knows the day of death. What's that? See, this is the America we live in, where cocaine and pornography are openly boasted about on the streets. This is what sin has turned this country to. You boast of your cocaine and your pornography on the streets. This is what an immoral and irreligious society, this is what it degenerates into. This filth, this subhuman corruption. I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry to tell you that if you don't believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you will drop into a bottomless abyss. You will burn in hell for your sin, sir. That's the truth. You'll burn for your pornography. You will burn in hell for your crack cocaine. You'll burn in hell for your lusts. And I would too, but by the grace of God, I'm not. And I want you to be saved. Likewise, young man, remember your Creator in the days of your youth. You may think you're invincible now. You may feel free from the fear of death now, but that's because you're young and foolish. If you're wise, you would fear God. If you were wise, you would tremble at his word. Oh, please remember your Creator in the days of your youth. Please, my dear friend, don't fight against God. Don't so foolishly, so rebelliously resist God. God is holy. God is righteous. God demands punishment for sin. And the Bible says the wages of sin is death. Every one of us deserves death and hell for our sins. But I've got good news today. I bear glad tidings of great joy. The Lord Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners. The Lord Jesus Christ can save you from your sin. If you are wise, you would make peace with God today. Oh, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. You say, what do I need to be saved from? Saved from yourself. Save from your sin. Save from your decadent, hedonistic self-indulgence. Save from the corruptions of the flesh. You must be born again. Oh, God bless you, my dear friends. Do you know the day of death? Do you know when you're going to die? No person knows the day of death. If you are wise, you would make peace with God today. Oh, Jesus said, I did not come to call the righteous. I came to call sinners to repentance. Unless you recognize you're a sinner, unless you recognize that you are filthy and unworthy in your own eyes, you do not qualify for God's redemption. If you are self-righteous and proud, there's no hope for you. Oh, please cease and desist this arrogance. Cease and desist this pride. God bless you. Look to the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, be humble before Him. I have good news, my friends, to those who appreciate the good news. The good news is that Christ died according to the Scriptures, that He was buried, and on the third day, He was raised according to the Scriptures. Oh, my dear friends, do you know God today? Do you know Jesus? If you know Jesus, you have truly been blessed of God. Blessed are those eyes and those ears who have not yet having seen God, who have not yet heard His voice directly, they still believe. Do you believe on Jesus Christ? Your life is a gift from God, my friend. Every breath you have, every bite of food you eat is God's mercy, is an extension of the grace of God.
God is dead.
God is dead? No, when you die, you're going to find out the hard way, young man. When you die, young man, you're going to find out the hard way that God is not dead. See, how foolish is that, sir? How foolish to say God is dead. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. My sir, when you die, I'm calling you out, young man. Come here. Let's talk. Let's talk, man. Don't keep walking. What are you afraid of? You know what the Bible says? The fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. Do you fear God today? The fear of God is the beginning of knowledge. Do you know why? God gives you, young man, God gives you your life and your breath. God gives you the power to get wealth. God gave you your mother. God gave you your father. God gave you American citizenship. Have you no fear of God? Have you no fear of God? The Bible says the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. How foolish it is to say there is no God. What type of madness would possess a person to deny God's obviously self-evident existence? It is abundantly self-evident. It is, oh my friend, it is conspicuously, indubitably true that God exists. There is a righteous and holy God. You cannot deny the existence of God. For a short time you can, but when you die, then you'll find out the hard way. Please, my dear friends, don't die in your sin. God bless you. God bless you. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you shall be saved. Saved from what? The Bible says you call His name Jesus. Why? Jesus saves His people from their sins. Bhagwan bahut parishuddhe. Hum sab pape. Hum sab pape. Miku telugu telasa. Miku telugu. Telugu telasa. Yesu prabhu andu viswasamanchu. Yesu prabhu pradanchandi. Yesu prabhu pradanchandi. My friends, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved. Do you know Jesus today? Do you know God? The Bible says it is appointed unto men once to die and then judgment. We're all going to die one day. Every person will stand before God. If you are wise, you'd make peace with God today. My dear friend, God bless you. I pray that your heart is sensitive to God's truth. I pray that you are aware of your need of God. Don't die in your sin. Don't die as a fool challenging God. God bless you, young person. Do you know when you're going to die? Do you know when you're going to die? You could be hit by a bus, God forbid. You could be hit by a stray bullet. You could have cardiac arrhythmia. You could have a congenital heart disease that you are unfamiliar with. You could die of cardiac arrhythmia, of a heart attack at any moment. You don't know that. Your life is in God's hands. Every cardiac beat, every heartbeat you have, every breath you take, every drop of water you drink is an extension of God's mercies. You're running on borrowed time, my friends. You're running on borrowed time. Your life is in God's hands. Your days are numbered. If you are wise, you would apply your heart to get wisdom. You would number your days. And you would fear God. The fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. Are you a fool or are you wise today? Do you love God or do you hate the truth? Do you love to persist in rebellion? Do you indulge your wicked fantasies? Do you live in the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of your ego, the pride of life? Oh, my dear friends, all that is in this world, even your own ego, all of it will be burned up. It will be destroyed with extreme prejudice by God's holy angels. Make peace with God today before it's too late. You don't know the end. Do you know the end? Do you know when you're going to die? Do you know when you're going to be hit by a bus? Come and talk to me, friend. Why are you so rude, man? Let's talk. Do you know when you're going to die, young person? Young man, do you know when you're going to die? Do you know when your life will be required of you? We're all going to die. Every person will return to dust. Doesn't matter how educated you are. Doesn't matter how much money you have or how much money you don't have. It doesn't matter how moral, immoral you are. If you don't have Jesus Christ, you must repent of your sin and your righteousness. Many of you today, sadly, are righteous in your own eyes. Are you righteous in your own eyes? Are you proud in your own eyes? Oh, the Bible says that wisdom lifts up her voice. Wisdom cries aloud at the head of the noisy street. Wisdom cries aloud. Jesus said, young person, Austin, can you hear me, Austin? Jesus said, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Jesus said, go and preach the gospel. The Greek word is kerygma. It means to publicly announce the kingdom of God. Do you love Jesus Christ, sir? Do you love God? Are you a friend of God today? The Bible says, what's that?
God's not real, bro.
God's not real?
Yeah.
You're going to find out the hard way when you drop dead. This young person, this man right here says that God is not real. Where do you die, man? Where do you die? You're going to find out the hard way. Let's talk. Let's talk. Come here, bro. Let's talk. Come on. What's your name?
Jalen.
Nice to meet you, Jalen. So, why do you say that God is not real? I can't prove him? Let's talk. My friends, the Bible says that it is appointed unto men once to die and then judgment. See, when we die, we're all going to be confronted with the hard reality that there is a God. And I pray that you're not so foolish today as to deny God. What type of madness would possess you to say there's no God? It is abundantly self-evident. It is obvious, it is indubitable that there is a God.